Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Captain Marvel Monday. I hope everybody's doing well these days and trying to get back to the somewhat of normal and not making people angry this week and making them unsubscribe because I didn't do a Captain Marvel Monday. I'm sorry I did it on Wednesday. Today we're doing it on Monday. Thank you very much. Captain Marvel concept art gives Danvers an out-of-this-world costume. This is from CBR.com. I found this very interesting because, you know, how often does concept art actually become the real thing? An early take on Captain Marvel's outfit from her Kree days has showcased in a recent released piece of concept art from her Kree days. So that would be in the past? Is that? I'm not sure what they're getting at. Obviously, this is not it. That's just from the regular one. Concept artist Constantine Sekeris has shared an early version of the Captain Marvel costume worn by Carol Danvers. This version of the costume, which... So I guess this is this for the new movie or from the old one? Posted in his Instagram, had a less colorful and more sleek look than the final design. Okay, so this is for the movie that already came out. Of the image, Curious said, this is another Captain Marvel early exploration of her Kree costume, a bit alien with a red palette and different hairstyle. I have to admit, I finally saw Endgame, and I know people are going to hate this. Well, some people hate this. This is okay. But her in the so-called Karen haircut with the short hair, I think works much better. I don't know why. She just looks better with it. With that, the character, I don't necessarily Brie Larson looks that better, much better with it, with a short hair. But I thought it fit the character better than the long hair. And I did like the inside joke of, what, you're going to get your haircut again? With Rocket. I thought that was funny. Here's another cat. Okay, sorry. Did this design at Marvel Studios and the visual development team led by Andy Park. So this is interesting. So straighter hair, I guess. Why is it? What is moving? Oh, okay. Look at this in chrome. Yeah, even the dimensions look alien. The arms look way too long. The legs way too long. Brie isn't that tall nor that skinny. So I don't think that would work very well. Almost like a Spider-Man suit. Yeah. Yeah, it's very reminiscent of some of the Venom, Spider-Man-ish type things. Yeah, the proportions look very strange. Her legs look very long. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know if I like that. Here's another example. So if I click this, what's going to happen? Okay, so we've got a close-up of it. I guess is that Brie Larson? Or it doesn't matter. Her neck's not that long too. Yeah, the whole thing is looks kind of alien. You know, the neck is long, the arms are longer than they should be, the torso is kind of weird. I mean, the hips look okay, I guess. Hips to waist ratios, but that seems like that's pretty long too. Here's another Captain Marvel early expression of her Kree costume, a bit alien. It is a bit alien, I will say that. Did this design, okay, was on this cool project. cool's not spelled with, unless you're talking about cigarettes. It was a lot of fun, a lot of, actually, that's two words, a lot, not, all right. Sorry, this guy's foreigner, so anyway. Released in early 2000, okay, so that, and they didn't say it brought in $1 billion. Reprisal role in Endgame, we know that. A sequel to Captain Marvel has been announced with a projected release date of July 8th, 2022. Okay, all of you Brie Larson apologists, there it is. There it is. I'll even highlight it for you. You keep putting in my comments. That's great, but July 8th. Anna Boden and Ryan Fleck, who directed the first film, won't be returning for the sequel, and a new director has yet to be confirmed. Oh, I thought they were returning. For some reason, I thought they... Okay. However, it has been announced that the WandaVision writer, Megan McDonald, will be drafting the screenplay. Now, that is something we've had multiple people claim that they're going to do that, but I think that's the second time I've seen that, and it's been a while. So, okay, it's on Blu-ray, and no mention of the $1 billion. Okay, John Ridlehoover, you're supposed to always put in there that it grossed a billion. At the box office to spit on the haters. Actually, I don't know if I like it or not. I really don't. I think and I'm talking about the design, the proportions of the person, you know, I think they got their arms way too long. I mean, this looks like an alien. okay, humanoid alien, where the torso and leg section are longer and the arms are longer than they should be. They're not, I don't think they're supposed to stop like right here. You know, think of Michelangelo and the man outstretched. And there's a condition when your arms are actually too long. I forget what it's called. But this guy was my freshman year of college. A guy in the next dorm room had it. He was like 6'2", but had a reach of like 6'6". Kind of like, you know, Michael Phelps has that same thing. Anyway, so what do you think of the costume design? Let's just kind of, you know, forget how well the character is drawn and, you know, proportionate. To me, it does look alien. And so this is against the all green one, I guess. This is before she takes on the Captain Marvel colors. Yeah, I don't know how that would have fit in when she selected new colors. I mean, that would have been a completely new design. It does look alien. I will say that. I don't know if I like it any better than... I mean, I thought what they had is pretty meh. And this is like just a different kind of meh to me. Maybe not. So what do you think of this possible concept that was in the ideas pile? Do you like it better? Do you like it worse? Let me know in the comments below. And thank you so much for stopping by Captain Marvel Monday. And we'll see you next week. Thank you and goodbye. Yep. Okay, cool. That's right. 3 and 2 and 1.